Hello there, everybody. I promised to make a video about my experience in FDR, so here goes. I must have found FDR in the beginning of 2008. At the time, I was studying philosophy at university. And I was looking for some introductory videos on philosophy, and that way found Steph's Introduction to Philosophy series, to which I'll link in the comments. Now, I had to delay in my studies, and that was because for a year and a half I stayed home to take care of my mother, who was not actually really ill. She had some things that needed sorting out, but for the most part she was hypochondriac. And an issue was that she had physically threatened me and guilted me to stay home, and I really wasn't safe around her. So, yeah, I stopped having a life of my own and started feeling hopeless after a while. So, in that way, finding FDR was really crucial for me. It was really almost life-saving, because I started thinking about suicide if I couldn't get out of this situation. And FDR helped me to get that perspective that, you know, it's kind of wrong of my parents to abuse me, to neglect me, to not respect me as a person, to just use me. And this possibility that, you know, I can just leave, I can just go away, that really helped me a lot at the time. So I fled home. I didn't tell my mother. It was, yeah, she became very angry, started throwing stuff, so my sister called the cops. But I got out and went to live on my own. I got off contact with my parents, but not with my siblings, and I also kind of removed friends from my life. So on the one hand, Free Domain Radio was helpful because it helped me get out of a nasty situation. On the other hand, it gave me more problems, because it gave me a very jaded, very negative worldview in which most people are corrupt, not consistent, not living philosophically, not living according to truth. They aren't anarchist, and that made me kind of isolate myself from others, feel estranged in this whole world. There was a small meeting of Freedomainers, and that's where I met my boyfriend, and we had a relationship for almost 3 years. And it was at the end of the relationship, around that time, that I started questioning FDR. One of the things that happened was that a mutual friend of ours, he questioned me having contact with my siblings, that my siblings still hadn't taken a stance against my parents, so why was I in touch with them? So this was strange to me. I was like, who are you to say with whom I associate or do not? It's not up to you. And at this point, a few other Freedomainers that I knew had left Freedomain Radio, and these were people I looked up to and respected, so that planted some seeds of doubt. It's mainly when I found FDR Liberated and Liberating Minds, which I'll also link to in the comments, that I found out how critics are being dealt with at Freedomain Radio. Like, I've heard some complaints about banning, but the excuse was always, well, it's banning of trolls, we don't need trolls here. But I looked through the posts and topics, and the people who've been banned, and often they had good, consistent critiques, rational, not offensive, not trollish. So yeah, that was kind of a dent in the image I had of Steph and the Freedomain Radio. And I started to have the fear myself that I would get banned if I made critical sounds. So I did post on Freedomain Radio about these bannings, about people perhaps not having the best experiences by following Freedomain Radio advice. And you know, sure enough, my posts were deleted. I was banned. I sent Steph and James P multiple mails asking why did I get banned, and I never got an explanation. So that was kind of it for me. And I have to say it was a really huge disappointment, the whole experience, because when I was in the middle of Free Domain Radio, I really believed that this was a movement that was going to help set the world free, make the world more rational. I believed that universally preferable behavior was finally the proof of objective morality. I started studying psychology with the aim of becoming a psychotherapist who would help heal trauma and in that way heal the world. So I found out that Stefan, who claims that virtue, integrity, consistency, honesty, courage, that these are very important virtues to live by, that he doesn't practice it in his own life, and that he in fact has multiple skeletons in his closet, while he claims that, you know, you gotta take responsibility. Need to be honest and open and vulnerable. So yeah, there are the people, the critics who have been banned, who didn't get like a good rational reply, not a good debate. An example of this is how he treated the determinists. There were those who were too hastily in the judgment of their parents and, you know, in the end, came back to their families, reunited again. There's possibly a suicide associated with Free Domain Radio that also, you know, threats about that were deleted on Free Domain Radio boards. Christina's hearing, of course, her reprimand, that's been a taboo topic, and Stefan recently lied on the Joe Rogan show that she wasn't reprimanded, although she was. And of course, recently the DMCA claim against True Sheeps, for copyright infringement, and then saying no, it's not about copyright at all, but you know, he's using the law, the gun, so to speak, against True Sheeps, which you know, he self vehemently opposes. So, yeah, the hypocrisy these days and the flat out lying and everything, it's so in contrast to what I used to think that Steph represented. It's really sad. So one of the worst things is, I think, that Free Domain Radio proclaims to be about personal and political freedom, but once you get in it, there are all these rules and criteria that you need to subject yourself to. Like, for example, you need to get rid of people who aren't anarchists or free domainers because these are people who want you dead, according to Steph. So you need to leave your parents because they didn't know universally preferable behavior. You also need to leave your siblings. At least they have to pick a side, you or your parents. People have to admit that they're anarchists or otherwise they are okay in favor of using violence against you. So that leaves you with very few people who are good enough to deal with. And in Free Domain Radio, I remember there was a lot of critique also back and forth between free domainers and psychoanalyzing each other and criticizing each other for, you know, degree of virtue or not that you live in your life. So it's a place that actually breeds conformity and, you know, listening to Steph as the great reference point and leader instead of what philosophy ought to do is helping you to think for yourself, think critically, independently, realistically, and, you know, actually help you feel freer and not more restricted to all these ridiculous rules. So, yeah, once I started speaking out against FTR, my Free Domain Radio friends left me very, very fast. Like, it doesn't matter what degree of intimacy we had before, I was critical of Free Domain Radio of staff, so I was a bad person, so I had to be thrown out. There was just no other way, and I wasn't even changing my stance on parenting or anarchism or anything. I'm still against abuse against children. I'm still for free association. I'm still against initiation of violence. You know, those things haven't changed. So yeah, that was a bit of my experience. If anyone has any questions, let me know. I'll answer them. I really hope that those who get stuck in FDR, in that mindset, will be able over time to, you know, slowly free themselves and find, you know, the intellectual freedom, the emotional freedom to really be yourself, really think for yourself, really create your own life. And I hope that those who have the food have kind families that they can return to. I know in my case I have contact again with my father, who has admitted that that he made mistakes. With my mother it's still a bit difficult, but she has changed as well, so I'll just see how that goes. Alright, thank you very much for listening, and I'm awaiting your questions or comments. Bye.